Hello and welcome to worship this Christian Family Sunday, Sunday, May 9th, 2021. And of course, it is also another very special day for those who may not take advantage of showing gratitude throughout the year as often as they might like to. And so, happy Mother's Day to all the women out there, mothers, nanas, grandmas, aunts, friends, anyone who is a female mentor. We wish you a happy Mother's Day. I'd like to welcome you and thank you for joining me and the people of Wardsville and Glencoe Presbyterian Churches as we worship our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. My name is Reverend Deb Dolbear-Van Bilson. In community news this week, the mission moment that our national church encourages us to be praying about is entitled Ministry of Hope and Care. Fernando's dream of becoming a police officer seemed out of reach when he and his brother were children living in the streets of Misk, a rural village in Romania. 12 years later, he attends university and is closer to fulfilling his dream thanks to Samuel House, where Fernando and his brother found a welcoming home. Samuel House is a Christian social ministry of the Reformed Church in Romania, in a specific district, providing nutritious food, education, and after-school care to children from disadvantaged families. Presbyterian Sharing has been supporting this important ministry of hope and care since 2014. Let us pray this Christian Family Sunday. We pray for the health and well-being of families and that the relationships within them are marked by peace, love, trust, and care. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. I'd also like to share another good news moment with you, and our church has received a thank you from Camp Kintail on Lake Huron, and this is where Reverend Teresa McDonald Lee and her husband Jonathan are ministering. And if you recognize the name, Teresa is Robert McDonald's oldest daughter. And inside, we receive this to the Willing Workers. Glencoe Presbyterian Church Willing Workers, thank you so much for your donation. We truly appreciate all of the ways you support Camp Kintail, especially in this time of great uncertainty. Blessings. We hope you have a happy Mother's Day, Reverend Teresa, and a happy family day with your husband, Jonathan, and three daughters, Ella, Lucy, and Anna. I'd like to share a prayer called Spirit of Life for the young people in this time of uncertainty as well, especially when they're not returning to in-class learning at this time. Lord, bring your hope and happiness into the lives of young people. Guide them as they search for meaning and purpose in their lives. Take special care of those who struggle with issues of self-worth, rejection, and despair. Safeguard them from danger and bring peace to their minds and hearts. May your grace enfold all young people of the world and draw them closer to you. Amen.
Come thou fount of every blessing, tune my heart to sing thy praise. Streams of mercy never ceasing, call for songs of the loudest praise. Teach me some melodious sonnet sung by flaming tongues above. Praise the mountain fixed upon it, mount of thy redeeming love. Here I raise my epiphany, I hope by thy good pleasure safely to arrive at home. Jesus, send me when a stranger, wandering from the fold of God. He to rescue me from danger interposed his precious blood.
I'd like to wish a happy birthday to Heather Holman on the 12th, and on Thursday the 13th, we wish a happy birthday to Christopher Stocking and Lois Woolner. If you or someone you love is celebrating a birthday or an anniversary this week, we wish you a blessed and wonderful day. And here is a little reminder of what happens at school. A teacher gave her class of second graders a lesson on the magnet and what it does. The next day, in a written test, she included this question. My full name has six letters. The first one is M. I pick up things. What am I? When the test papers were turned in, the teacher was astonished to find that almost 50% of the students answered the question with the word mother. And on that note, happy Mother's Day to all of you who are mentors, mothers, moms, mamas, and a female influence in the lives of those around you. May God bless you this Mother's Day. Our call to worship is on the screen. Let us sing to the Lord a new song, for God has done marvelous things. Let us make known the Lord's victory, for God's steadfast love covers the whole earth. Let us sing joyful praises and join all creation to worship God's holy name. The praise selection is on the screen.
I'm not afraid.
성성 다 바쳐서 주님 경배합니다.
미연은 빼는 버리자염 닌 문들 마트럼 바랑음
ourselves and our confessions to God. Let us pray. Holy God, the power of your love is beyond comprehension, the breadth of your compassion without measure. In Jesus Christ, you have met us in the midst of life's joys and challenges and shown us what it means to love and be loved. You have entrusted us with the greatest commandment to love one another as Christ has loved us. In this time of worship, we offer you our love and loyalty, seeking to learn more of what love and loyalty mean for us in the midst of our joys and challenges. Receive our prayers and praise, and through the power of your Spirit, draw us closer to each other as friends and followers of Christ, our risen Lord. Merciful God, we confess we often find it difficult to love others as you commanded. Though we intend to do your will, our priorities lead us in other directions. We seek our security before the well-being of others. We fulfill our own desires rather than act for the common good. We justify our own interests and fail to understand the cost they take on the earth, and other people. Forgive us, redirect our priorities, and renew our commitment to live out your love, even when it demands more of us than we expect. All this we pray through Christ our risen Lord, and hear us as we also pray the powerful words of our Lord's Prayer, convicting our hearts as we focus on our relationship with you, and only you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Friends, hear the good news. Who is in a position to condemn us? Only Christ. And Christ died for us. Christ rose for us. Christ reigns in power for us. Christ prays for us. Let us believe the good news of the gospel. In Jesus Christ, we are forgiven and made new by God's generous grace. Thanks be to God. Amen. On May 13th, the church worldwide marks Jesus' ascension, which assures us that he will be present with his followers throughout every generation and in every culture and context. As we offer our gifts in thanksgiving, remember that they continue to honor Christ Jesus as Lord of all times and all places. I encourage you to give what you are able and called to give to your local church that you love, the charity of your choice, or as the Lord leads you to give. Let us pray. Generous God, we bless you for the gift of life that you give us, renewed through Christ's love. Bless us and the gifts we bring, so that our lives may reflect the hope and renewal we have found in Christ throughout our community and in the world you love. In his holy name we pray. Amen. I'd like to share a reading with you today, and I see that the words are going to be backwards, but I hope you'll listen and you'll enjoy this story. This was a gift from one of my dear friends in the Wardsville Presbyterian Church in St. John's. Hugs are great. Hugs are great when you're kind of shy. Hugs are great when you're in a jam. Hugs are great when you're feeling weary. Hugs are great anytime. Hugs are great. And even though we're in the midst of the pandemic, let's remember that we can share hugs in different ways than physically. If we're not able to be there for one another, we can share a hug by making contact with those we care about, those we love, however that form may be. So please know that in Christ, he is with you. You are not alone through this, and we will get through this. Let us pray. Lord, we thank you for hugs. We thank you for the people in our lives. We thank you for the love we share. And we thank you for the opportunity to meet with one another and worship together online, across all time and space, all to your glory. In Jesus' name, amen. And our praise selection is on the screen.
Do you think it's enough to praise God just on Sundays?
No!
Well, how about on Sundays, Wednesdays, and Fridays? Okay, what about 5 days of the week and half the day Saturday?
No!
You're right. Here's what the Bible has to say.
Psalm 145, verses 2, 10, and 11. Every day I will bless you and praise your name forever and ever. All your works shall give thanks to you, O Lord, and all your faithful shall bless you. They shall speak of the glory of your kingdom.
Every day I will bless you. Every day I will praise your name. Every day I will bless you. Forever and ever and ever and ever. Every day I bless you. All your works shall give thanks to you.
Oh Lord, oh Lord.
And all your faithful shall bless you. They shall speak of the glory of your kingdom. Every day I will bless you. Every day I will praise your name. Every day I will bless you. Forever and ever and ever and ever. Every day I bless you. All your works shall give thanks to you.
Oh Lord, oh Lord.
And all your faithful shall bless you. They shall speak of the glory of your kingdom.
Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, every day.
Every day I will bless you.
Every day I will bless you.
Every day I will praise your name. Every day I will bless you. Forever and ever and ever and ever. Every day I bless you. Every day, every day.
Every day I'll bless your holy name.
Every day I'll bless your holy name. I will bless you.
I'll bless you at night, too.
Our first reading is found in the book of Acts, chapter 10, verses 44 to 48. Let us hear God speak to our hearts. The Gentiles received the Holy Spirit. Even as Peter was saying these things, the Holy Spirit fell upon all who were listening to the message. The Jewish believers who came with Peter were amazed that the gift of the Holy Spirit had been poured out on the Gentiles too, for they heard them speaking in their own tongues and praising God. Then Peter asked, "Can anyone object to their being baptized now that they have received the Holy Spirit just as we did?" So he gave orders for them to be baptized in the name of Jesus Christ. Afterward, Cornelius asked him to stay with them for several days. And turning to the Gospel of John, chapter 15, verses 9 through 17. Jesus is speaking in this. "I have loved you even as the Father has loved me. Remain in my love. When you obey my commandments, you remain in my love, just as I obey my Father's commandments and remain in his love. I have told you these things so that you will be filled with my joy. Yes, your joy will overflow. This is my commandment: love each other in the same way I have loved you. There is no greater love than to lay down one's life for one's friends. You are my friends if you do what I command. I no longer call you slaves, because a master doesn't confide in his slaves. Now you are my friends, since I have told you everything the Father told me. You didn't choose me. I chose you. I appointed you to go and produce lasting fruit, so that the Father will give you whatever you ask for, using my name. This is my command. Love each other. Now may the words of my mouth and the meditations of our hearts be pleasing to you, O God, our rock and our redeemer. Our message this week is entitled, You Are Worthy to Be Here. Our faith is not something we often talk about, not like the weather and sports or politics or a pandemic when you're in the middle of that. Yet Jesus said, we are to be bearers of fruit. Last week, I closed with these words. The issue, the truth in Christ, relies on the question, how do you treat people? Let go of judgment, let go of revenge, live in forgiveness. If you are in Christ, people will be able to see the fruits of your life in terms of your compassion, your love, and your attitude, all in your actions. Jesus says, I am the vine, bear much fruit. So, have you been bearing much fruit this week? Jesus said, we are to be bearers of fruit. Each one of you is a branch. You are connected to the one true vine. You represent the church wherever you go. And when you're faithful, it is contagious. And so, just like the church building in a community stands out and people notice when it's taken care of, when there's things happening, so too are you the presence of God among people of God's abiding love. Each one of you is a visible presence in the community, no matter where you're serving. Now, if you study the life and words and parables and sermons and actions of Jesus, Scott Hosey writes that you will find an eternity's worth of things you should do. But there was precisely just one thing which was so vital that Jesus actually went so far as to phrase it as a command. And that was to love each other. We are to love one another, cherish one another, even lay down our lives for one another if need be. And it is all an extension of being a branch on Jesus, the true vine. Apparently, Jesus knew that if we could do just this one commandment, everything else would follow. If you bring a child, say, to an ice cream parlor, Hosey says, you won't need to start issuing rules which insist that the child order a cone, eat it, enjoy it, find it delicious, and so just generally have fun. Once the child gets into the ice cream parlor, the rest follows. So also with love. If we can't do this, nothing else will work either. We can love one another, and the rest does follow. I hope you'll enjoy this next clip as you think of the relationships in your life where people have bared much fruit and changed your life for the better. May God bless you this day and always. Amen.
Mommy's here. Oh, my sweet boy.
Do you have any idea what time it is?
Can you say mama?
Huh?
Mama. Mama.
Atta boy.
Open big wide for Mama. What a big boy you are. What a big boy you are.
Okay. Now we can't go to church with jelly all over our face, can we? Oh my goodness. What are you doing with that snake?
You go put that snake back in the hole right now.
All right, buddy. Yeah. Way to go. All right, buddy. Hey. Oh, buddy. You okay? You all right?
Now I lay me down to sleep. I pray the Lord my soul to keep. If I should die before I wake, I pray the Lord.
Hey, Mom.
Mommy needs just a minute. Please.
Hey, Mom. I think you look pretty no matter what. Even when your hair looks really weird.
Oh, Mom!
Go straight there. And come right back.
Hold here, honey!
Oh, Mom's here! It's okay! Oh, you're okay! Oh, thank you, Lord. Thank you. Thank you.
Oh.
Mom, wait. Stop it.
Mom? Dad? I asked Beth to marry me.
Well, what'd she say?
Welcome to the family.
I'm so happy for you.
Hey, Mom.
Where's that grandbaby?
Oh, I see you.
Oh. Yeah, nice to see you too.
Hey, Mom.
Oh, it's okay.
It's okay.
You did great.
What's that?
The children. You did really great. I always knew you'd be a good dad, but you did really.
Mom, what are you doing? Of course you are.
Come sit with me.
You know, I was thinking just the other day about what a wonderful mom you are. I mean, God really blessed me with a great lady. You're my mom. You've always been there for me. Even when I didn't want you to be. And nobody ever believed in me like you do. Thank you. I love you, Mom.
And I love you, son.
The good news of this passage is that you are chosen by God and He loves you so much that He laid down His life through His Son, Jesus Christ, for you, for your salvation, so that you may never be separated from Him ever again. And this good news is for each and every one of us. So let us celebrate by loving one another. Because if we do not love our brothers and sisters whom we have seen, how can we say that we love God whom we have not seen? Each time that you look into the eyes of another person, you have seen a little part of the heart of God. Let's love one another and bear good fruit as friends to our Lord and our Savior. Amen. Please join me in our closing prayer. God of our lives and our loving, we thank you for the signs of resurrection that are all around us, showing that life is stronger than death. Give us the grace to recognize and embrace the gifts of new life that your love makes possible for us as we pray for your resurrecting power to renew the world amidst all its challenges. God of home and family, today we thank you for our families. Especially we thank you for our mothers and grandmothers. We are grateful for their love and attention, their hard work and their deep hope they have cherished for each one of us. We honor before you each mother, grandmother, and great-grandmother who has died. And we pray for all those who have felt isolated from their families in these months of pandemic. Reunite us in your love, we pray. God of connections and compassion, today we thank you for our friends and relations, for the neighbors and fellow citizens who help to make our lives complete. We thank you for smiles shared, helping hands offered, commitments honored, and we pray for all those around us who are facing particular challenges this day. Restore our hope with your love, we pray. God of courage and new possibility, today we pray for all those who have felt life and love slipping through their fingers in the times of distancing we've had to endure, and for those who have struggled with their physical or mental health, whatever the reason. We pray for communities trying to sort out how to recover from the pandemic and for all those worried about their personal future. Encourage us with your love, we pray. God of forgiveness and renewal, today we pray for those whose relationships are in need of repair and for all who work for peace and reconciliation in the face of deep divisions. We pray for families, churches, communities, and countries facing conflict. And we ask that your Spirit open our hearts and minds to deeper understanding. Reconcile us through your love, we pray. And Lord, we commit now to you those who are in our hearts and minds this day, in our church, in our community, in our families, and around the world. All this we pray through Christ our risen Lord. Amen. Our closing praise selection is on the screen.
Our Lord, for we have known it, the Lord.
Let us go in the joy of God's grace, freely given to us in return for one thing, that we love one another as God loves us. Let us go in peace, and may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore. Amen.
You are tempest tossed when you are discouraged, thinking all is lost. Count your many blessings, name them one by one, and it will surprise you what the Lord hath done.
Have a blessed week and happy Mother's Day.